Graph matrices is another method for white box testing. A data structure called graph matrix can be quite useful for developing a software tool that assists in basis path testing. A graph matrix is a square matrix whose size is equal to the number of nodes on the flow graph. Each row and column corresponds to an identified node, and matrix entries correspond to the connections between nodes. Each node on the flow graph is identified by numbers, while each edge is identified by letters. The graph matrix is nothing more than a tabular representation of a flow graph. By adding a link weight to each matrix entry, the graph matrix can become a powerful tool for evaluating program control structure during testing. The link weight provides additional information about control flow. In its simplest form, the link weight is 1 for a connection exists, or 0 if a connection does not exist. Referring to this figure, each node on the flow graph is identified by numbers, while each edge is identified by letters. A letter entry is made in the matrix to correspond to a connection between two nodes. For example, node 3 is connected to node 4 by edge B. To this point, a graph matrix is nothing more than a tabular representation of flow graph. In the matrix, each letter has been replaced with a 1 indicating that a connection exists. This graph matrix is called connection matrix. In the figure of the connection matrix, each row with 2 or more entries represents a predicate node. We can directly measure cyclomatic complexity value by performing arithmetic operations. So connections is equal to number of row with total number of entries minus 1. So the connections in row 1 is number of connection entries is 1 minus 1 equal to 0. Similarly, connection in row 2, since there is no entries exist in row 2, the connection is 0. In row 3, there are 2 connections. So the connection number of connections is 2 minus 1 equal to 1. Similarly, in row 4, we have 1 connection. In row 5, we have 2 minus 1, 1 connection. The cyclomatic complexity V of G from this graph matrix can be calculated by finding the sum of all connections plus 4. That is, the sum of all connections is already given in as row 1, row 2, row 3, row 4, row 5. Summing all these values together plus 1. So 3 plus 1 equal to 4 is the cyclomatic complexity of this graph matrix V of G. Another method of white box testing is control structure testing. Control structures are tested using this type of testing. The basis path testing technique that we described is one of the number of techniques for control structure testing. In this section, other variations on control structure testing are discussed. This broaden testing coverage and improve the quality of white box testing. So other control structure testing include condition testing, data flow testing, and loop testing. One of the major objectives of control structure testing include the selection of this test case to meet various criteria for covering the code. Test cases are derived to exercise control over the order of the execution of the code. Coverage-based testing works by choosing test cases according to well-defined coverage criteria. The more common coverage criteria are the following: statement coverage or nodes coverage. Every statement of the program should be exercised at least once. Branch coverage or decision coverage. Every possible alternative in a branch of the program should be exercised at least once. Then condition coverage. Each condition in a branch is made to evaluate to true and false at least once. Decision or condition coverage. Each condition in a branch is made to evaluate to both true and false, and each branch is made to evaluate to both true and false. Conditional testing. In this kind of testing, various test cases are designed so that the logical conditions contained in a program can be exercised. A simple condition can be defined as a single Boolean variable or a relational expression. The conditional testing method tries to focus on testing each and every condition which is existing in a program and gives a path to execute. The advantages of conditional testing include measurement of test coverage of a condition is simple. Then the test coverage of condition in a program makes guidance for the generation of extra tests for the program. Data flow testing. Testing in which test cases are designed based on variable usage within the code. Data flow testing looks at the life cycle of a particular variable. The two major types of usage nodes are PUs, predicate use. The variable is used when making a decision. For example, if B is greater than 6, it is a PUs type data flow testing. Then CUs, computation use. The variable is used in computation. For example, B is equal to 3 plus D. With respect to the variable D, the computation values are checked in data flow testing. Loops are the cornerstone for the vast majority of all algorithms implemented in software, and yet we often pay them little heed while conducting software tests. Loop testing is a white box testing technique that focuses exclusively on the validity of loop constructs. Four different classes of loops can be defined: simple loops, concatenated loops, nested loops, and unstructured loops. Testing occurs by varying the loop boundary values. For example, in the for loop, I is equal to 1 to I equal to 0, I less than max index, I plus plus. Again, while current temperature greater than or equal to minimum temperature. Just to remind these different types of loop testing loops, I am showing this flowchart so that you will remind what is simple loop, nested loop, concatenated loop, and unstructured loop. Now let us discuss about the testing, loop testing in each of these different cases. So while testing of simple loops, the possibilities can be 1. Skip the loop entirely. 2. Only one pass through the loop. 3. Two pass through the loop. 4. M pass through the loop, where M less than N, where n is the maximum number of allowable passes through the loop. Then n minus 1, n plus 1 passes through the loop. So these are the following set of tests that can be applied to simple loops. Testing of nested loops. If we were extend to test approach for simple loops to nested loop, the number of possible tests would grow geometrically as the level of nesting increases. So the approach that will help to reduce the number of tests include: start at the innermost loop, set all other loops to minimum values, then conduct simple loop tests for the innermost loop while holding the outer loops at their minimum iteration parameter values, add other tests for out of range or excluded values, then work outward, conducting tests for the next loop but keeping all other outer loops at minimum values and other nested loops to typical values. Continue this kind of testing until all loops have been tested. Concatenated loops can be tested using the approach defined for simple loops if each of the loops is independent of the other. However, if two loops are concatenated and the loop counter for loop 1 is used as the initial value for loop 2, then the loops are not independent. When the loops are not independent, the approach applied to nested loop is recommended.